Mathematics is regarded as the queen of all sciences. For long, the role of mathematics was limited to purely academic domain. Now, the role of mathematics is not restricted to purely academic domain. It has entered the domain of technology and industry. New fields in mathematics such as operation research, control theory, signal processing, and cryophotography have been generated which need technology. Technology can reduce the effort devoted to tedious competitions and increase students' focus on more important mathematics.
Our still looking at integers, and our today's lesson is multiplication of integers. So when you are solving integers, you have to follow the rules. They are the rules that you are supposed to follow every time we are solving multiplication of integers. So we have the rule number one here. The rule number one states that we have the rule number two. Rule number two states that positive multiplied by another positive gives us a positive. We have rule number three. Positive multiplied by negative gives us a negative. We have the rule number four, which is negative multiplied by a positive and gives us a negative. So when we are multiplying integers, we are supposed to follow the rule. We can't solve integers minus following matter. And if we are having same signs, like we have in rule number one and in rule number two. So when we are having same signs, the answer will always give us the positive. So same signs always gives us a positive. So we have rule number three and rule number four. These two rules they are for different signs. We have positive and negative. In rule number four, we have negative and positive. And always know that when we're having a different sign, our answer will always give us a negative answer. Is it clear?
Example number one. Positive 3 times positive 5. The answer is here we have a positive times positive is equal to positive. And we have the numbers. So if you have seen, we have positive 3 times positive 5, the answer is positive 15.
that we have discussed so far. Let us now look at our fourth example. We have positive 4 times negative 2. Positive 4 times negative 2. So the first thing that you do, first you multiply the signs. When you multiply the signs, you can now multiply the numbers. So positive times negative, which will give us a negative. Positive times negative, it will give us a negative. And then 4 times 2, it will give us 8. 4 times 2, it will give us 8. So, here we can say that the first thing when you have such a question, the first thing that you do, you multiply the signs. Remember the rules that we have discussed. Rule number 1, negative times negative, it will give us a positive. And then rule number 2, a positive times a positive, it will give us a negative. And then rule number 3 and number 4, it will give us a negative because we'll be multiplying signs that are different. So now let us look at our fifth example. Negative 4. one, which is negative 2 times positive 4 times negative 4.
Okay, having been given the following exercise, which I'm sure we'll all enjoy it, having had as good the examples, shall we go through the solutions of the exercise together? For our first exercise, we are given the question positive 6 times positive 2. Now, I'm sure we all remember from the examples, positive times positive is going to give us a positive. And then 6 times 2 is going to give us a 12. Therefore, positive 6 times positive 2 is equal to positive 12. Our second question on our exercise is saying negative 4 times negative 4. Now, I'm sure we all remember negative times negative is going to give us a positive. Always the same signs. Negative times negative is going to give us a positive. Positive times positive is going to give us a positive. So, we are saying negative 4 times negative 4 is going to give us positive 16 as our answer. So if you got positive 16, then your answer is correct. We move on to the third question on the exercise, which is saying negative 4 times positive 5. So negative times positive is definitely going to give us a negative. Okay? So negative times positive is giving us a negative. And then we shall multiply 4 times 5, which is going to give us 20. So for our third question, negative 4 times positive 5, our answer is negative 20.
In continuation to the questions given here, we have the fourth question, which says positive 2 multiplied by positive 4 multiplied by negative 4. We know to say when you multiply integers having the same signs, the answer is positive, and when you multiply those having different signs, the answer is negative. So positive multiplied by positive will give us positive. Multiplied by the other negative, result in two contrasting signs will give us negative. So we write the negative sign there. Now, let us now deal with the numbers. We know to say 2 multiplied by 4 multiplied by the other 4 will give us 32. So we write our 32 like that. Okay. The fifth question was negative 6 multiplied by negative 2 multiplied by negative 3. So now this is a unique situation which we need to take care and look at critically. We've had the first thing there, we said when we multiply integers having same signs, the answer is positive. Now this is a unique situation here. Let us examine the thing nicely. Negative multiplied by negative, why would we say it's what? Positive. Now, there is another negative here. When you multiply these two, we are having a positive result. And then there's a negative one here. So we are having now two different signs. So which will result in an answer being negative? So this may somehow alter the rule. Otherwise, it deals with the two integers in multiplied results in positive with the same sign. So here we are going to have 2 negative as our answer. Now let us multiply the numbers. 6 multiplied by 2, the answer is 12. And then multiplied by 3 there, it's 36. Therefore, negative 6 multiplied by negative 2 multiplied by negative 3, the answer is negative 36. Okay, so in this lesson, where multiplication of integers was concerned, we have learned to say when multiplying follow the basic rules which were outlined on the board. We had the first rule which talked about the first two rules which talked about multiplication of two integers having same signs, where the answer was coming out as a positive. The other two rules were talking about multiplication of two integers having different signs, the answer was coming out as a negative. So if we can put these rules at our fingertips, we are going to find that multiplication of integers is not going to be a problem. So this is the lesson for today. We are going to have the next one in the next lesson. Thank you so much for watching. To be continued.